Hey there, and welcome to Eureka. My name is Sandra, and I work with the Ottawa Public Library. Now, you've probably had a chance to look at some icicles dripping off of a roof, or maybe you've seen pictures of icebergs floating in the ocean. Ice can be an absolutely gorgeous medium. From icicles to icebergs, from sculptures to snowflake crystals. There's all sorts of different ways to look at ice. Now, what if I told you that you and I could make some art with ice today? How's that sound? Sounds pretty good to me too. So let's take a look at what we're going to need today. Activate your creative mind, warm up your creative fingers, and let's get melting. I have here a baking sheet with a raised edge. That'll just help catch any of the water that's melting away. I've put it on top of a towel to protect my table because it's going to get kind of wet and cold, and it's just nicer that way. We're also going to want some ice that we've molded in a couple of different containers. You can use large containers, you can use pie plates, you can use bowls. Just stick them in the freezer for a while, and hopefully they'll come out a little easier than that one. There. We're also going to want to use some salt, and I'll keep that handy right here, and some food coloring or some paints. So you can use watercolor paints, you can use some thinned out acrylic paints, whatever it is that you have on hand. Again, I'm just going to put those to the side. So we're going to be looking at the different ways that ice melts. Now we know from winter that adding some salt to ice on the sidewalk helps it melt faster. And that's because salt lowers the freezing temperature of ice, which means that it freezes at a colder temperature than it would normally. So it starts melting faster. So we'll just let that sit for a minute, and we can see how the salt is starting to melt in. Now that we've let the ice do its thing for a minute or two, I'm just going to take a spoon to grab a couple of drops of my paint and food coloring. And you can see it's starting to spread out in what looks like rivers. We're definitely seeing more of them on this small ice cube because it's going to be melting faster than this large one. So what we could do is add another pinch more salt on one side just so we can see what happens, you know, for science. Once again, we're just going to let that sit for a minute. All right, so we're already starting to see a lot more melting on this one here. Can you see that? And I'm definitely starting to see it a bit more here. So let's take a look at what happens if we add a little bit more color. Now, you might find it easier to use an eyedropper if you have it. There we go. Look at those patterns. Now, I'm just going to put the purple to the side for the moment. And that way, we can start experimenting with the blue. Shall we add a little more color? See what happens? Oh, we've got some great rivers going on there. All right. So I'm definitely seeing what look like some cracks in the ice that have started to form. And over here, the blue and the purple are really starting to meld together. And you can see, especially on this side here, that the colors are starting to go down the sides. Now it's pretty warm in this room, which is definitely helping things melt a little faster. You can see that we're starting to get a puddle underneath this particular one. And this ice cube's taking a lot longer.
And that's because of the differences in surface area.
So if something is large and it's either quite warm or quite cold, the very size of it helps it stay that way longer than a smaller one. That's because the inside is protected by the outside. So what do you think? Should we add a little more salt just to see what happens? I'm going to try and get some on the sides here. Just see so that we can maybe get a few more rivers. We'll just let these sit for a little bit and see what happens. Well, it looks like our icebergs are starting to float away. Once they've got some water under them, they start getting pretty mobile, don't they? Well, that tray is on a little bit of an angle. So we can see that the water's starting to form around this one here. And the top of that ice cube is really starting to almost look like snow. Let's try adding a touch more color. So we'll go with some purple this time. And we can just see that sinking right through and down into the middle of that ice cube. And let's see how this one's doing. Oh yes, this is definitely sinking down too. It's not spreading around nearly as much. And the water seems to be flowing even faster around this large one. Thank you.
All right, so here are a few things for you to think about. What if I'd heated up the plate or put the ice cubes in a bowl of warm water? They'd melt much faster, wouldn't they? That's one of the reasons people do talk about climate change and how it can warm up the oceans. But let's also see what happens if we use up the last of our color. We're just going to add a big old dollop right here. Oh yeah, check that out. And, oh, that's spreading right through. Both of them, it's leaking right through the ice and heading into the meltwater. That's pretty gorgeous, isn't it? Oh yes, and check out the sides. Oh, there's this one spot in particular right on the side. Check out that crack right there.
All right, so there we have it. Isn't it amazing the way the ice reacts with the salt and the paint? It turned out beautifully. So, I hope this got you thinking about what's happening in our world with the icebergs and our polar caps. If you're looking for more information about climate change and what's going on the planet today, be sure and check out the library's website at www.biblioottawalibrary.ca. There's all sorts of books, videos, and activities you'll find there. And if you had fun today, be sure to hit the like button below, and you can subscribe to our channel to make sure that you're notified when our next video comes out. So until then, I hope you have an amazing day, and I'll see you soon. Bye.